We will talk today about model reference state estimation in series parallel configuration of the estimator. In this diagram, I want you to see the controlled plant, and this controlled plant is a real physical process that will work as a reference model in our scheme. The state vector X is the state vector of the real physical process. It's supposed to be utilized in a control system for a state variable feedback. However, it looks like in this particular situation, the state vector is not sampled frequently enough, and the accuracy of its measurements also is not sufficient for control application. Now, you understand that there is a way of building a state observer, and building a state observer is something that you know from our 462 or 510 classes. However, in order to build a state observer, we have to have the exact mathematical model of the real process. And in our situation, which seems to be more practical, it is not available. Our knowledge of the controlled plant is insufficient. And because of this, we're building a state observer or state estimator. We're using this series parallel configuration because when I presented the parallel configuration last time, I spoke about the sticky point. In order to establish, solve the Lapunov equation, if you remember, we were supposed to have information on the matrix AM of the reference model. And we haven't complete information about the control plant. So this was a sticky point. You will see now that we are avoiding this sticky point by using the series parallel configuration of the adjustable system. In the adjustable system, you see the integrator. In the output of the integrator, you see the state vector Y. State vector Y supposed to be the representation, the estimate of the state vector X. However, being generated by a computer simulation code, Y could be sampled with any frequency, and we can expect to have good accuracy for values of this Y vector. You also have to keep in mind that we're using information on the state vector of the controlled plant. However, the frequency of sampling may be sufficient for adaptation, but not sufficient for control applications. Therefore, state vector Y will be used instead of X in the control system. Well, this is the integrator. In the output of the integrator, you see this vector Y. In the input of the integrator, you're supposed to have Y prime, derivative of the state vector. And this derivative consists of three components. The first component is the control effort U pre-multiplied by adjustable matrix B. Then you have the state vector of the control plant or of the reference model pre-multiplied by the adjustable matrix A. And then you can see that error is extracted, the discrepancy between X and Y, and this error vector is pre-multiplied by some filter K, which is fixed filter, and with minus sign it is applied at the summing junction. And sum of these three terms constitutes Y prime. Y prime is integrated and turns into state vector Y. The next one, you can see that we have the error. Error is converted into vector of intermediate variables V. And the filter that performs this conversion, matrix filter, is called G. And later you will see that G comes out of the Lyapunov equation. And then you see the adaptation mechanism responsible for adjusting matrix A of the adjustable system and adjusting matrix B of the adjustable system for the input of the adaptation mechanism. We have to use intermediate vector V, we have to use control effort U, and we have to use state vector of the adjustable system Y. And now we can go over the equations. This is the typical state equation for the controlled process. State vector is X. This is the state equation for adjustable system. And please realize that the state vector is Y. However, right here, we have state vector X of the reference model, which indicates that we use the series parallel configuration. Then we have matrix B multiplied, adjustable matrix B multiplied by the vector of control efforts, and then we have this term minus KE. This K is a specially selected square matrix, and the purpose of K will be clear to you very soon. The state generalized error is defined as X minus Y. And then you see the adaptation mechanism that consists of three components. The first component is conversion of state generalized error E into vector of intermediate variables V. G is the matrix filter that performs this conversion. And then you can see the adaptation mechanism itself, the definition for matrix adjustable matrix A, definition of the adjustable matrix B, and you're supposed to remember that the adaptation mechanism A is a function of V and T, and B is a function of V and T, supposed to be flexible enough, because we will use this flexibility to make sure that the Popov integral inequality is satisfied. And because of this, we use this integral plus proportional configuration plus initial conditions. Again, integral plus proportional part plus initial conditions. The next what we will do, we will compute the equation for the derivative of the error. This derivative is equal to the difference between X derivative and Y derivative. This is the expression that utilizes definition of X prime and Y prime. They put together, and after making some algebraic transformations on this expression, we're getting this equation. If you will look at this equation, you will realize that matrix K represents, or I would say this part of the expression, represents, is associated with the linear time invariant part of the system that's supposed to be strictly positive real. And this part of the expression represents the nonlinear time varying part that has to be hyperstable or satisfy the Popov integral inequality. Again, the ability to satisfy this Popov integral inequality is assured by this configuration, integral proportional for adjustable matrix A and adjustable matrix B. I will call this equation equation 1. This equation 1 was obtained for serious parallel configuration of our system. And I want to remind you of similar equation that was obtained for parallel configuration. In this equation, please take a look. The linear time invariant part has fundamental matrix AM that comes from the controlled plant. Controlled plant is not fully known to us. It is only partially known control plant. So we were supposed to satisfy the Lapunov equation using matrix AM that is not known to us in many cases. So I guess this equation is less practical than the equation that we have for the series parallel configuration. And therefore, we will be using this equation, and I guess this one will be used only for your mathematical sophistication, I would say. This equation should be forgotten at this point. How about matrix K? Matrix K is the fundamental matrix of the linear time invariant part of the system. And this fundamental matrix, as you understand, is responsible for the convergence rate of the error. Now, this matrix K should be assigned using pole placement according with the desired settling time for the estimation process and the very nature of the estimation process. The convergence of the estimation process could be oscillatory, or it could be purely exponential. This is defined by the choice of matrix K. And after this matrix K is chosen, it will stay constant. You know, last time we spoke about definition of matrix function phi 1, phi 2, psi 1, and psi 2. Now, let's take a look at these functions. You see, these functions are used to compute time-dependent matrix, adjustable matrix A and adjustable matrix B. Phi 1 and phi 2 are used for matrix A adjustable, and psi 1 and psi 2 are used for matrix B adjustable. Now, here you have a very formidable, very formal definition for matrix function psi 1, matrix function psi phi 2, matrix function psi 1, and matrix function psi 2. In this expression, we have positive definite matrices FA, FB, GA, GB. Now, it was said that matrices FA prime, FB prime, GA prime, and GB prime, those matrices, they could be zeros, which means that we necessarily have to have phi 1, but phi 2 is optional. Necessarily, we have to have psi 1, but psi 2 is optional. And of course, we will try to simplify our approach as much as it could be done. Now, for the sake of simplicity, we can choose matrix FA, this one, to be just a constant matrix. It is allowable. It will be constant, positive constant K1 times unity. Matrix FB, this one, could be also chosen as a constant matrix. It will be positive constant K2 times unity. Matrix GA and matrix GB, I can use unities for these matrices. Then our definition of phi 1 and Psi 1 would be very simplistic, or at least will be much more simple. Look, matrix function Phi 1 will be constant times vector V times transpose state vector of the adjustable system. But this V vector is equal to matrix D times error. So this is the expression that is quite a down-to-earth type expression. For phi 2, we will use 0. For psi 1, we have this expression. It is a constant times vector V times transposed control effort. However, V could be replaced by matrix filter D times error times transposed control effort. And psi 2 is 0. And this matrix filter D supposed to come from the Lapunov equation. It will be obtained by solving the Lapunov equation. Why? Because this is our way to obtain a strictly positive real time invariant part. You know, this expression represents the transfer matrix of the linear time invariant part. You know, it's a very typical configuration for state variable description, except right here we would normally have matrix B, but for matrix B we use unity in this situation. So indeed, this is the transfer function for the linear time invariant part. How to make it strictly positive real? By making sure that D matrix, this one, comes out of the Lapunov equation. In this Lapunov equation, matrix K is the one that we chose. Matrix D is the matrix filter that we need. And minus Q matrix is a positive, arbitrary positive definite matrix taken with minus sign. And I always use unity for this matrix, which is acceptable. So this is how we're supposed to define filter D, by solving the Lapunov equation. Now we have to make sure that our nonlinear time varying part is hyperstable or satisfies the Popov integral inequality. How this is achieved? You know, our nonlinear time varying part picks the vector V and generates vector W. And vector W is the one that is applied with minus sign to the transfer matrix of the linear time invariant part. So this is the expression describing the nonlinear time varying part. In this expression, we know how matrix AS is defined, how adjustable matrix B is defined. So there is no problem with the definition of the adaptation mechanism effectively, because earlier it was presented that this choice would allow us to satisfy the Popov integral inequality. Now this phi 1 is defined by this expression, and psi 1 is defined by this expression. What's left? What's left is to implement the system, and first, we will discuss the model reference design using our third-order example. And then we will consider another example so that every single aspect of this design will be clearly engraved in your memories. All right. So this is the state equation of the controlled process, which serves as a reference model. The point is, matrix A and matrix B of the reference model of the controlled process may not be accurately known to us. The important thing for us is not knowing this matrix A and this matrix B, but being able to monitor X vector and vector U with the frequency sufficient for the adaptation procedure. Now, the adjustable system is our observer. And here you can see that state vector derivative of the state vector Y prime is equal to adjustable matrix A times vector X. Why X? Because of series parallel configuration. Now, this is adjustable matrix B times vector U of the control efforts. And this is matrix K that we will establish ourselves. It's a fixed matrix, and it is multiplied by vector of errors. And errors are the E is the discrepancy between the X and Y. This is our choice of matrix K. What this choice tells you? It tells you that matrix K is a matrix with eigenvalues minus 4, minus 5, minus 10. It's a diagonal matrix. It's very easy to see its eigenvalues. It's very easy to understand that any system with such a fundamental matrix is supposed to be stable. It also could be said that in a system like this, the settling time of the error estimation of the estimation process will be what? 1 second, because of the slowest eigenvalue in the system. Our goal is to make sure that as time approaches infinity, the error, the discrepancy between X and Y, will become zero. And it's supposed to happen for any initial conditions, any initial x0, any initial y0, any initial values of adjustable matrix A, and any initial values of elements of the adjustable matrix B. We're talking perfect asymptotic adaptation. Perfect asymptotic adaptation is assured by building a negative nonlinear, negative feedback nonlinear system that will be globally, asymptotically stable. All right, we will start from establishing the best guess model of the process. Without having this best guess model of the process, especially if we do simulation, not working with the real process, we would never have state vector X, and will not be able to apply control effort U. As I said, these parameters are not that important for us. The next, take a look at the computation of the vector V. This computation is part of our adaptation mechanism. We're extracting error E, pre-multiplying it by filter G, and we have G times error. It's a third order system, so we have V1, V2, and V3. We multiply 3 by 3 matrix by 3 by 1 matrix, and we're basically getting a vector. This is the first component of this vector, happens to be equal to V1, second component of the vector equal to V2, and the third component of the vector equal to V3. The gains, FA, FB, GA, and GB, we will define as follows. We're looking for simplicity. And therefore, FA and FB we will make equal to unity. And GA and GB we will have 0.1 times unity matrix. 0.1 is the positive constant. And matrices FA prime, FB prime, and so on, we will make 0. Which means that we will be using only the integral parts of our adaptation mechanism. Only integrals and initial conditions will be used. You will see it later. Now our goal is to build matrix function phi 1. Later we will integrate this matrix function and we will get adjustable matrix A. This is a 3x3 matrix. It has 5-1-1, 5-1-2, 5-1-3, and so on. And let's see how it is defined. First of all, I have matrix FA, which is unity. It is multiplied by vector V, defined right here. And it is multiplied by the transposed state vector of the adjustable system. And then it is multiplied by matrix GA. It is unity times 0.1. And if you would go through all these matrix operations, you will get phi 1 1 equal to 0.1 V1 times Y1. Phi 1 2 is equal to 0.1 V1 times Y2, and so on. This is how we're getting particular components of the matrix function phi 1. For matrix function psi 1, we have total of 9 elements, and they are defined as follows. In this definition, you see the unit matrix multiplied by vector V, multiplied by the transposed vector of the control efforts, and multiplied by matrix GB, I think it is called, that is equal to 0.1 times unity. And when you will go through all this matrix operations, you will see that this is psi 1, 1, this is psi 1, 2, this is psi 1, 3, and so on. What's missing? We still do not have V1, V2, and V3. To get them, we will solve the Lyapunov equation to obtain matrix G. Matrix KT is known, defined. Matrix Q is unity. This is the same equation rewritten. This is matrix K transposed, but it's a diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix being transposed does not change. Matrix D, matrix K, and the minus unity. Computer tool allows us to obtain very easily matrix D. It happens to be, in our case, a diagonal matrix. This is matrix D. And later you will see that having diagonal matrix D will be very useful to get simple definition of vector V. As a matter of fact, vector V is defined right here. Right here. The early definition of vector V was this. Now, since matrix D is diagonal, this is 0. We have only this term. This is 0 and this is 0. We have only this term. And those two are zeros. And we have only one term left. Having vector V allows us to define psi 1, psi 1 1, psi 1 2, psi 1 3, and by integrating these psi components, we will get adjustable B11, B12, B13. Now, having this vector V enables us to define Φ11 and Φ12 and Φ31, I wrote here. By integrating these phis, we're getting A11, A12, A31, and so on. I did not write them all. Now, keep in mind that we have to add initial conditions, and initial conditions supposed to come out of the best guess model for the control plant. You know, this type of effort each of you supposed to complete as a part of your homework assignment number 5. However, you will have a second order, 2x2 matrices, not 3x3. Your problem will be even simpler. As a matter of fact, my next example is basically something that you will be doing in your homework assignment. You can use it as a cliche, you can follow it. However, I would prefer that you would do it on your own. One way or another, the situation is this. We have the true control plant, and only the Almighty knows matrix A and exact matrix B. We may have some idea what they are, and this idea is reflected by the best guess definition of the control plant. This is the control plant that nobody knows. However, what's important for us, we have the X measurements, the state vector, and measurements of the control effort applied to this control plan. The next, what you can see, is the state observer, which is our adjustable system, and we have series parallel configuration for it. This is adjustable matrix A. It is multiplied by state vector X, not Y, X, because of the series parallel configuration. This is adjustable matrix B, and it is multiplied by U. And this is matrix K that we chose. It is my choice, and I am taking responsibility for choosing this matrix K. I have a diagonal for simplicity. I placed eigenvalues along the diagonal as diagonal elements, and you can see these eigenvalues are negative. So we shall not expect any problems with matrix K. And of course, matrix K is multiplied by errors vector, vector E. This is the definition of vector E right here. The next, what we will do, we will solve the Lyapunov equation. You know, I suppose to call this matrix not P, but D. For some reason, I don't know why I call it P. Earlier I call it D, but name doesn't change anything. This is the matrix filter that will be used to convert error into vector V. It is called P here. Well, what's a big deal? It's called P. So this is matrix K transposed. This is matrix K. Since it is diagonal, transpose and non-transpose is the same. It is equal to minus Q. Q is unity matrix. Everything is fine. Computer gives me this result for matrix P. And here I can use matrix P to compute vector V. And the fact that matrix P is diagonal helps me. My expression is simple. For this is V1 and this is V2. Again, don't be confused, please. This is supposed to be called matrix D. Okay? Well, I called it P. The next what you should see is that I have matrix function phi that has elements phi 1 1, phi 1 2, phi 2 1, and phi 2 2. C1 is a positive constant, and this is the definition of phi 1 1, phi 1 2, phi 2 1, and phi 2 2. This definition includes variables V1 and V2 that earlier were defined. And this is matrix Psi with elements Psi 1-1, Psi 1-2, Psi 2-1, and Psi 2-2. And it's equal to a constant C2, positive constant. And this is definition of Psi 1-1. This is definition of Psi 1-2, and so on. The next what we have to do, we have to define matrix A, adjustable matrix A, and adjustable matrix B. Elements of the adjustable matrix A are defined by integration of elements Psi 1-1 plus initial conditions, integration of elements Psi 1-2 times plus initial conditions, and so on. And adjustable matrix B is defined on the element-by-element basis. Look, this is element 1-1. It is defined as integral of Psi 1-1 plus initial conditions, integral of Psi 1-2 plus initial conditions. This should be Psi, of course. Psi 2-1 and Psi 2-2 plus initial conditions. And of course, initial conditions come out of the best guess model. You know, this is just verbiage. It is mathematics, but you know, we actually follow some recipes already established in the textbook. We do not do any mathematical derivations. It is just sequence of mathematical definitions. However, the main challenge is to implement everything what we said, and the only way to implement it is to build a simulator. Implement our system in the simulator, in the simulation environment. First of all, I want you to see a simulation setup representing the true controlled process. All these elements are supposed to be unknown. However, we're supposed to have access to X1 and X2. And of course, we are responsible for applying the U1 and U2, the control effort to the process. The next what you're supposed to see is the adjustable system, our state observer. Look, it's a series parallel configuration. Don't be confused. Therefore, I have X1 and X2 state variables of the reference model multiplied by adjustable coefficients of matrix A. These are coefficients of the first row of matrix A. Then you can see control effort component U1, control effort component U2, and they are multiplied by elements of the first row of matrix B, and they are also adjustable elements. They are variables as far as our simulation is concerned. But then don't be confused. This is component of the error one, multiplied by the appropriate diagonal element of matrix K. It was minus 0.2, and it is minus 0.2 right here. And when you will add these things and integrate them, you're getting state variable of the adjustable system Y1. Similar stuff you do in order to obtain state variable Y2. Look, X1 and X2, multiplied correspondingly by adjustable A21 and A22, elements of the second row of matrix A, elements, components of the control effort U1 and U2, and they are multiplied correspondingly by elements B21 and B22, representing the second row of adjustable matrix B. And then, of course, you have the second component of the error multiplied by the appropriate element of matrix K, which happens to be -0.05. What is happening here? This is very trivial part. We compute errors. X1 minus Y1. This is a symbol of subtraction or sign change. X2 and Y2. We're getting error 1 and error 2. And we multiply them by components of the matrix P. Matrix P, diagonal matrix. And its components are 2.5 and 10. And after this multiplication is performed, we're getting variable V1 and variable V2. What's next? Here you can see the adaptation mechanism. This adaptation mechanism, first of all, defines element Phi 1 1 is constant gain times variable V1 times variable Y1, then it is integrated, then initial conditions are added, and we're getting adjustable element A 1 1. Here we're getting element Phi 1, 2. We have constant, we have V1, we have Y2, and we have this multiplication, we integrate the product, we add initial conditions, and we're getting A1, 2. In the similar fashion, we're getting A21 and A22. Now here, this part features computation of the adjustable elements of matrix B. To get element B11, we have to multiply constant by V1 by control effort U1. Product is integrated. Initial conditions are added from the best guess model. Guess what? We're getting the B11. Repeat this one. Here we get element Psi 1, 2, constant times V1 times U2. We integrated, we add initial conditions from the best guess model, we have element B1, 2, which is defined as a variable because it will change, because V will change and U will change. So they are functions of time, actually. They are variables, not constants. And here you see the entire model reference system. You see the process. It has two inputs, two control efforts. For control efforts, U1, I use step. For U2 control effort, I use sinusoid. It has X1 and X2. Okay, the adjustable system you also saw is supposed to have Y1 and Y2, and adaptation mechanism. This is this adaptation mechanism responsible for adjusting elements of matrix A in the adjustable system and matrix B in the adjustable system. What's next? The next, I want to tell you this. I perform simulation study. Perform simulation study. And I perform the simulation study with adaptation mechanism disabled and with adaptation mechanism enabled. And apparently, I lost this picture, but you will see this picture very soon. You will see the actual simulation. And I will include this picture. Don't worry about this part. But with the disabled adaptation mechanism, you can see that there is a quite significant discrepancy between the state vector x1 and y1 and state vector x2 and y2. The next what I want to do is oh, wait a second. Here we have pictures got shifted. Results of simulation with adaptation mechanism enabled. Look, we have very good consistency between x1 and y1, and even better consistency between x2 and y2. Why it happens? It happens because of the typing in. You see, I'm getting results from the computer tool, and these results have many digits after decimal point. Okay, but when I type them in the simulator, I'm dropping some digits. I have used only 2 or 3 digits after decimal point. This is why the simplification, the round off, has greater effect on this state variables than it has on this state variables. The next that I want to do is to run with you the actual simulation. The simulation is done in software vSim. I want you to see the control process defined, the true control process defined. I want you to see the adjustable system defined exactly as I was talking to you earlier. You know, it's a very good simulator. I can make various things with this simulator, improve the picture and so on and so forth. Now, and this is the adaptation mechanism. Now, in order to run simulation with the disabled adaptation mechanism, I will disconnect this constant gains. And let me show you what will happen. I'm running my simulation, system, and go. And what you can see is the quite different x1 and y1, and quite different x2 and y2. The adaptation mechanism is disabled. The next I will connect constant gain values. Now adaptation mechanism is enabled. And take a look. System and go. As I said, quite good x1 and y1 and virtually perfect x2 and y2. And probably I can play a little bit with the constant gains and improve this run, but it's not that important. You see very clearly, take a look. You can easily visualize how the adaptation mechanism is trying to force state vector y2 to follow state vector x1. Okay, so this is quite convincing result. I want you to realize that when you do this type of simulation, make sure that you showing, presenting the point. Let's say you work in the industry, you support your the engineering efforts by simulations. Make sure that you run the simulations properly, choose appropriate regime for simulations. Then your contribution will be visible. Now, the last issue that I want to discuss today is your homework assignment number 5. What is special about homework assignment? You must do it. You must do it. So the homework assignment is very straightforward. You have plenty of examples given to help you to do this assignment. So I guess you have to do this homework assignment. I plan to cover 2 more topics on model reference control. One topic will be linear model following systems. And the second topic will be model reference control systems. And then you will have your test. Of course, after you will complete homework assignments and answer numerous questions that you have. But 2 more topics and then test. Thank you.